So during this process, the chloroplast is there, which will pick up the which has the rubisco. Now this rubisco in these conditions, the rubisco, instead of picking up carbon dioxide, picks up the oxygen. So the RuBP now will react. It's a 5-carbon compound, will react with oxygen. There is no carbon here, so that means the total number of carbons will remain only 5. So if you remember the RuBP topic, RuBP was 5-carbon compound which picked up 1 carbon in the C3 cycle to produce a 6-carbon compound. So total, because 5 plus 1 becomes 6. Now and then it splits into 2 molecules of 3-carbon compound. Now in this case, what exactly happened is rubisco carries 5 carbon, oxygen carries no carbon. So now this 5-carbon compound is going to split into 3 plus 2. So the 3-carbon compound is that same PGA or 3-phosphoglyceric acid, but the another one is the phosphoglycolic acid, which is a 2-carbon compound. Now this compound is formed, that's why it is called as C2 cycle. Now this PGA will enter into C3 cycle, but there is a loss of this compound because now this compound will undergo a C2 cycle. So now this phosphoglycolic acid will liberate its phosphate group and will change into glycolic acid. Now this glycolic acid is transported out of the chloroplast into the peroxisome. Now you have already done peroxisome topic in the cell organelles chapter. Now this glycolic acid undergoes oxidation to change into glyoxylic acid with the liberation of H2O2 or hydrogen peroxide. Now this is poisonous, so it is quickly changed into water and oxygen. Then this glyoxylic acid undergoes transamination, that means it will pick up the amino group from glutamic acid, and this glyoxylic acid now will change into amino acid called as glycine. And finally this glycine will be shifted into mitochondria, where 2 molecules of glycine react together to liberate 1 molecule of ammonia, 1 molecule of carbon dioxide, and it undergoes even the oxidation to change into serine. Serine is another amino acid. So now you can check one thing here, there is liberation of carbon dioxide from mitochondria during this process, that's why it is called as photorespiration. Now this serine will be transported back into the peroxisome, and inside the peroxisome it undergoes change into hydroxypyruvic acid, which changes into glycerin acid, and this glycerin acid then is transported into the chloroplast, where glycerin acid is changed into PGA. So now you can see one thing here, finally phosphoglycolic acid is changed into PGA to enter into C3 cycle. But the wrong thing is, but there is already loss of 1 carbon dioxide, and then you can check one more thing, there is loss of ATP also. That's why it's a wasteful process. This cell is simply wasting its time and resources and finally forming a PGA again. So wastage of time. That's why this process is called in the NCERT as a wasteful process. So I hope this point is clear to you from the notes itself. Let me quickly go through the NCERT statement of this topic, because NCERT has not explained this topic much. So what is photorespiration according to NCERT is, in C3 plants, some oxygen does bind to the rubisco, and hence carbon dioxide fixation is decreased. Here RuBP, instead of being converted to 2 molecules of PGA, the RuBP binds with oxygen to form 1 molecule of phosphoglyceric acid and 1 molecule of phosphoglycolic acid in a pathway called as photorespiration. In the photorespiratory pathway, there is neither no synthesis of sugar, no synthesis of ATP, rather it results in the release of carbon dioxide. I just showed you release of carbon dioxide from mitochondria. So there is liberation of carbon dioxide and there is utilization of ATP in the chloroplast. So liberation of carbon dioxide from mitochondria and use of ATP in the chloroplast. So with the utilization of ATP, And in this photorespiratory pathway, there is no synthesis of ATP, no synthesis of NADPH. Therefore, this is a wasteful process. Now, this pathway does not occur in the C4 plant. This is because they have a mechanism that increases the concentration of carbon dioxide at the enzyme site. So I have already written the same thing in the notes. This takes place when the C4 acid from the mesophyll cell is broken down in the bundle sheath cell to liberate carbon dioxide. This results in increasing the intracellular concentration of carbon dioxide. In turn, this ensures that the Rubisco always functions as carboxylase and minimizing the chances of it to act like a oxygenase enzyme. So this is how photorespiration is a wrong process, and it occurs in the C3 plants and does not occur in the case of the C4 plant. We will continue the next topic in the next class.